فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
اوكي. سؤال الإمام البخاري رحمه الله عن أبي هريرة عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الإيمان بضع وستون شعبة. We mentioned what the word بضع means. فلبث في السجن بضع سنين. We said it is what. فالبضع ما بين ثلاث و إلى تسع. It's from 3 to 9, odd numbers. As Allah said, هم من بعد غلبهم سيغلبون في بضع سنين. صح. Okay. There's a riwayah that Imam Muslim narrated, which is ziyada. It adds additional things that Bukhari didn't mention here, which is what? It says, after it says al-imanu bid'un wa sab'una shu'ba, he says, fa'afdaluha, the highest of it. Okay. Somebody whose car is BT07XLC, Mercedes. They are blocking a car. ولا لي القفكي وتبابور كان ونمبر كي سي هاي BT07XLC. هكذا قاجي ماشي قف بابور كي سي وبلوغرينو يا. أفسمع لي وفي عين سمعنا. يا. My Somali is good, right? Excellent, excellent. In the future, I might start to teach in Somali, inshallah ta'ala. بضع وستون شعبة. So Imam Muslim has a narration which says, which is a ziyada that we don't find. It's an additional meaning, that benefit that we can take from it, that we won't find it in the narration of Bukhari, which is فأفضلها قول لا إله إلا الله. The best of it is the statement of لا إله إلا الله. And وأدناها إماطة الأذى عن الطريق والحياء من الإيمان. So this gives us, it tells us that لا إله إلا الله is the best. أفضلها, the greatest and the best is لا إله إلا الله. That's good. That meaning also brings that the iman, and it also shows us that iman, its levels and brothers, we're not all the same. Somebody will just stick to the asal of iman. Somebody, mashallah, will come with the wajibat, and somebody, mashallah, they will start going from extra additional things. Allah also mentions in the Quran, ثم أورثنا الكتاب الذين اصطفينا من عبادنا فمنهم ظالم لنفسه ومنهم مقتصد ومنهم سابق بالخيرات بإذن الله. The people are not of all at the same level. Somebody's just going to come with what would just keep them as a believer. Another person will say, no, I want to come with what is obligatory. And not only just to become a Muslim, but I will do that which is obligatory on me. And another person say, no, I just don't want obligatory. I don't want, فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازِ. That anyone who's protected from the hellfire and is taken to Jannah is saved. Now, that's not all I want. I want Firdaus. I don't just want to be saved from the hellfire. I actually want to go to Jannah, and I want to be in the highest level of Jannah. Because the Prophet said, إِذَا سَأَلْتُمُ اللَّهَ فَاسْأَلُوهُ الْفِرْدَوْسِ. If you ask Allah for Jannah, where should you ask? Our religion is teaching us to have lofty aspiration, high aspirations. Muslims are not people who are happy with minimum. We're not like that. Our Prophet is teaching this. Set yourself high goals. Set yourself high goals. Don't just say, oh, I want to enter Jannah. Don't say that. But ask for the highest station in Jannah. صح. That's how we are. So when you hear that the iman is of levels, don't stick to asalul iman. Come with kamalul wajib. Because if you don't come with kamalul wajib, then you're mutawa'adun fil nar. You might enter the hellfire for a while. So the benefits that we took from this hadith is, number one, that the iman is of different levels. The first benefit that we took from this hadith is tafawutu shu'ab al-iman, that the iman is of different levels. The second thing that we took from this hadith is the virtue of shyness. How important it is to be shy. A lot of people, they don't give importance to shyness. And we're going to expand on that very soon, inshallah ta'ala. Bukhari is going to bring a hadith of the issue of shyness. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is shy. Inna Allah hayyun kareem. Allah is shy and He's generous. So our sisters have lost shyness. Our brothers have lost shyness. You know, I remember when I was young, and I would go and pick up my youngest sister from school sometimes, secondary school. I used to hate picking her up from school because I used to take the bus. I don't know about Leicester, but in London, you go on the bus and you see the school kids coming on the bus. The girls, the way they shout and the way they act and the way they are, I used to hate it. It was the worst time of the day for me to just go pick up my sister from school. She had no shyness. The girl would shout from one side of the bus, let alone if you go on, if it's a double-decker bus and you go on the top deck. It's very sad, wallahi. And sometimes when you look at the person, you're like, Allah, subhanAllah, it's a Muslim. All this time, the girl who's shouting from the back, she's a Muslim. The whole bus, you can hear from downstairs, screaming with her friends. You go to bus stops, you see shocking things. Ikhwani, haya, shyness. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, إِنَّ مِمَّا أَدْرَكَ النَّاسِ مِنْ كَلَامِ النُّبُوَّةِ الْأُولَى إِذَا لَمْ تَسْتَحِي فَاسْنَعْ مَا شِيْتْ. If you don't have shyness, do what you want. What does it mean, do what you want? Meaning, if you don't have shyness, there's nothing stopping you. What can we say to you? What can somebody tell you? If you're not shy, then there's really nothing going to stop you. You're just going to dwell in every evil there is. Shyness is a thing that holds a person back and makes them think before they say something or before they do something. So shyness is something that boys have to come with. It's not only sisters. Haya, shyness. You see, it's not shyness to see a brother sagging his trousers. You see, his trousers are so back and it's so low. That's not shyness, man. Have respect to the people around you. Yeah. A woman, a Muslimah, shouting from one side of the road to the other side just because she wants to talk to somebody. That's not shyness. That's not shyness. So haya is very important. وَلِذَلِكَ it was said about the Prophet. The Prophet was more shy than a virgin who never left her room. The Prophet ﷺ كان أشد حياء من البكر في خذرها. The Prophet ﷺ was more shy than a virgin girl who never left her chamber. عليه الصلاة والسلام. Shy. Whenever the women would ask so many questions, they knew that the Prophet would be shy, so they would say before their question, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَسْتَحِيَ مِنَ الْحَقِّ. They want to ask him very detailed, explicit questions. So they say, Allah is not shy, Allah is not shy. So can you answer this question for us, Rasulullah? And sometimes the Prophet would be so shy that Aisha would grab the woman by the hand and she would take her out of the house and go far with her and say, this is the ruling. Rasulullah would be shy. So a nation who shyness is taken from them, amal min a'mal al-qulub is missing from them. They're very ill, this community. Worrying, if you're not shy. And of course, the shyness I'm speaking about is not the shyness that stops you from doing good. The shyness that makes you do good and achieve good, that's not what we're talking about. Are you with me? What did the poet say? What did the scholars say? They say, "Al-mustahi wal-mutakabbir la yata'allaman." The arrogant and the shy person don't learn. Now you are sitting here, you're listening to the dars. If later the question and answer session starts, and then you have a question, don't be shy to ask your question. وَلِذَلِكَ عَائِشَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهَا She said, رَحِمَ اللَّهُ نِسَاءَ الْأَنصَارِ May Allah have mercy upon the women of Ansar. لَمْ يَمْنَعْهُنَّ الْحَيَاءَ أَن يَتَعَلَّمْنَا Shyness did not stop them from learning. May Allah have mercy upon them. They wanted to know the religion, they asked. So it's not shy, it's the shyness that doesn't make you fall into evil. But the shyness that makes you do good, sorry, the shyness that stops you from good is not a praiseworthy shyness. Okay? And a lot of the youngsters, if you look at them, when they're with their parents, they're so shy like this. But in school, my mom used to, I wasn't a bad boy, alhamdulillah, when I was young. I mean, I was scared. But my mom, when she goes to school, but I would not speak much in at home, I'd just be quiet. When I went to school, I had friends, so I'd talk with my friends. You know, sometimes I'd get carried away in the classroom. Teacher would say, yo, be quiet. Abdurrahman, be quiet. And I might whisper and get in trouble for it. So sometimes my teacher, you know, parents' evening. Does it still exist? Parents' evening? They still have it, right? So my mom, when they tell her, she'd be like, what? It's like this? My son is like this? Because at home, I'm an angel. You youngsters know that. When you're at home, you're so nice. You know, wallahi, mom, I was in the room doing adhkar. All you would do, you're on Facebook all day. Yeah? But when you go outside, you're different. You're a total different person. You're living two different lives. At home, you come across in a different way. Well, that's why it's upon parents to observe their children every situation they're in. Because they act different when they're with you. And they are different when they go out and they see their friends, something comes out. Energy comes out. And they act different. Isn't that the case? Or am I just snitching on you guys for no reason? Yeah? Isn't that the case? صح? It's the case, eh? It's the case. The other benefit that we take from the hadith is that this individual by the name of Abi Salih, who narrated from Abu Huraira, that his name is what? His name is Dakwan al-Samman. That's the most famous one, and that's the majority of the narrations comes from him. Na'am.
Chapter: A Muslim is the one who avoids harming Muslims with his tongue and his hands. Narrated by Abdullah ibn Amr radiyallahu anhuma, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "A Muslim is the one who avoids harming Muslims with his tongue and his hands. And a muhajir, an immigrant, is the one who gives up all that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forbidden."
باب المسلم من سلم المسلمون من لسانه ويده.
الإمام البخاري he says باب chapter المسلم. The word المسلم is أي المسلم كامل الإسلام. A person's Islam is complete. That's the reason why we say that is because if the person leaves this, they don't become a disbeliever. The person who's a true Muslim, is the one who is what? من سلم المسلمون. Anyone who the believers, the Muslims, find from you safety, min lisanihi, your tongue, wa yadihi, and your hand. You don't harm the Muslims. You don't verbally harm them. And you don't physically harm them. You don't harm the Muslims physically, and you don't verbally. No one will ever hear a statement you said about them. Ya ikhwa, this is important, wallahi. That a person's statement is not, you're not going to the, speaking about people and causing them harm by backbiting them behind their backs, or speaking about their honor, or their family, or their people. A Muslim never. His statement will never reach anything he said bad about you. Also, he won't physically harm you. He won't physically harm you. So the believer should be one who's far from, what do you call it, harming the Muslims, and being what? Causing the Muslim people harm. Are you with me, brothers? Let the people find safety from you. Find safety from you. ولذلك the Prophet said, من يضمن, who will give me assurance? ما بين الحييه وما بين فخذيه أضمن له الجنة. Who's going to give me safety of what's between his two lips and what's between his two thighs? I will promise him Jannah. Your tongue. Promise me you're going to protect your tongue. Promise me you're going to protect your private part. You're not going to commit zina, and I will promise you Jannah. So watch what your tongue, this organ that you think is very, mashallah, smooth and fast, and it can speak. Be careful. احفظ لسانك أيها الإنسان لا يلدغنك إنه ثعبان كم في المقابر من قتيل لسانه كان تهاب لقاءه شجعان. Wallahi, protect your tongues. احفظ لسانك. Protect your tongues. How many people, because of a statement which they said, it was a cause of their death, or it became a reason why something happened to them? This is a ثعبان. This is a snake, brothers. Very dangerous organ. ولذلك the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إن العبد لا يتكلم بكلمة من رضوان الله أما من سخط الله لا يلقي لها بالا يهوي بها في نار جهنم. A person who says a statement that angers Allah, he doesn't really understand what he just said, the volume and the weight of what you've just said, right? You don't realize it. But because of that, you're dwelling in the hellfire so much. Be careful. ولذلك عطاء بن أبي رباح, when they spoke to him and they said, how have you reached the station which you reached? He said, I never spoke a statement except I asked myself 70 questions before I spoke. I'll ask myself, how could I? Should I say it? Should I not? The Prophet ﷺ was asked, من نجا حديثه عقبة بن عامر. The Prophet was asked, what's success? And what did he say? From the person who, what's success? From the things that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, messenger mentioned, was what? The person who gets control over his tongue is the person who's successful. Who makes sure he has control over his tongue. He knows what he says. ولذلك the Prophet also told us that a person does not wake up in the morning except his the body to kafiru lisanahu. It will speak to the tongue. اتَّقِ اللَّهَ فِينا, fear Allah in our affairs. فَإِنِ اسْتَقَمْتَ اسْتَقَمْنَا وَإِنِ اعْوَجَجْتَ اعْوَجَجْنَا. Fear Allah in our affairs. If you are steadfast, we're steadfast with you. And if you deviate and you go corrupt, we're going to be corrupt with you. In other words, a fight starts from a speech. So if you insult somebody, that hand is going to say, I'm going to join in. I'm going to have to physically finish it off, right? So fear Allah in what you say. Make sure you watch what you say, or else we're going to go in it with you. And if you're good, we're going to be good with you. Sah? Very careful. So a believer watches his tongue, and he watches his actions that he does to the Muslims. Watches it. Naam.
حدثنا آدم ابن أبي إياس.
آدم ابن أبي إياس العسقلاني, his name is, هو من كبار مشايخ البخاري. He's from the big teachers of Imam al-Bukhari. And he's from the shuyukhs of Bukhari that allowed Imam al-Bukhari to have what is known as al-thulathiyat. Are you there? Imam al-Bukhari actually has three narrations before the Prophet. And this is, by the way, the asanid that are Ali and Nazil. The chain is short, and when it's long, the a'immatul hadith, they used to fight for this. I mean, imagine having the shortest chain to the Prophet. This is something you die for, right? And Imam al-Bukhari has that. He has three chains of three individuals. Whereas Imam al-Muslim, the shortest he has is four. He could have got it. He could have got it through who? Abdullah ibn Maslamah al-Qa'nabi. If Imam Muslim narrated from Abdullah ibn Maslamah al-Qa'nabi, and because then Imam Muslim could have had a thulathiyat. But the reason why he didn't do that is because he was running away from who? Hayya? Who was he running away from? La? Abdullah ibn Maslamah al-Qa'nabi took it. Abdullah ibn Maslamah al-Qa'nabi is running away from an individual who he doesn't want to narrate from. Is Wardan. Yeah? Salamat ibn Wardan. He's running away from Salamat ibn Wardan, who's mutakallamu fi, who's basically questioned. Na'am. So Muslim, in Sahih Muslim, if you read it, you're not gonna find thulathiyat. The shortest that Imam Muslim has a ruba'iyat. As Bukhari, he has a thulathiyat. Tirmidhi has a thulathiyat. Tirmidhi is the student of a Muslim, and he has a thulathiyat. Bukhari, the Muslim doesn't. Hiya, haddathana.
قال حدثنا شعبة.
شعبة's name is أبو الحجاج أبو بسطام العتكي. شعبة ابن حجاج. His name is أبو بسطام العتكي رحمه الله. And he was أمير المؤمنين في الحديث في زمانه ومكانه when he lived. He was the first person who actually put in place this science that's known as الجرح والتعديل. Criticizing a narrator and praising a narrator. He actually made it a فن مستقل. After he started to research into a narration in which he was looking into. His name is who? His name is what? Shu'bat ibn Hajjaj Abu Bistam Al-Atakiyu Mawlahu. Naam.
An Abdullah ibn Abi Safar wa Ismail.
Fadal.
An Al-Sha'bi. An Abdullah ibn
Sha'bi, his name is what? Amir ibn Sharahil Al-Himyari. He's from the people of Hamdan. Naam. Alim al-Jalil min ulama'i al-Islam. Wa faqih min fuqaha'i al-Amsar. And he's a tabi'i. He is a tabi'i, meaning he met the companions. From the companions he met is Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As. Naam.
And Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As, radiyallahu anhu.
Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As is a sahabi, wa abuhu sahabiyun, he's a companion, and so is his father a companion. He's Abdullah, and his father is who? Amr ibn As, radiyallahu anhu. So they're both what? Sahabiyani, jalilani, mashhurani. They are two companions that are famous and that are very honorable. And Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As was the one who narrated the most narrations from the Prophet. Who narrated the most from the Prophet? Number one is who? No, Abdullah ibn Amr al-As. It's just we've received more narrations of Abu Hurairah. Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As, then Abu Hurairah says it. He said, what did he say? Kana Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As yarwi, he used to narrate when I never used to narrate. Abu Hurairah says this. Abu Hurairah says that Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As narrated hadith from the Prophet when I wasn't narrating. Because how many years was Abu Hurairah Muslim for? Before, how many years was he with the Prophet? Some scholars, they said three, and some said only four. 4 years he was with the Prophet Abu Hurairah. And he has the most narration. But the difference between it is Abu Hurairah sat down to narrate. He made his whole life to narrate the hadiths of the Prophet. Are you with me? Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As, it was said, he got carried away with ibadah. Sahib ibadah. He used to pray a lot. He used to fast a lot. He busied himself with himself. So his narrations that have come to us is less in quantity than the narrations of Abu Hurairah. But who narrated from the Prophet more? Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As. So he is known as a Zahid min al-Zuhad. He was an aesthetic individual. He boycotted his dunya. He turned towards the hereafter. And he used to be kana qalilu sha'n. He used to take little from this world. Very simple clothing. It's a very simple life. Radiallahu ta'ala anhu wa an abihi.
عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال المسلم من سلم المسلمون من لسانه ويده والمهاجر من هجر ما نهى الله عنه.
So here we take المسلم من سلم المسلمون من لسانه ويده. We took والمهاجر is the person who migrates. And who's a مهاجر? A مهاجر is the person who migrates from what? ما نهى الله عنه. That which Allah has prohibited سبحانه وتعالى. A مهاجر, a true مهاجر is what? مَنْ هَجَرَ مَا نَهَى اللَّهُ عَنْهُ. If you do hijrah, you boycott what Allah tabarak wa ta'ala prohibited from you. Then there are three migrations. The word hijrah, it comes in three meanings. One is land, one is sins, and one is an individual. صح? A person. Are you there? Hijrah. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, لا هجرة بعد الفتح ولكن جهاد ونية وإذا استنفرتم فانفروا. Hijrah never stops. It's to migrate from the land of the disbelievers and it's to migrate to the land of the believers. That's when the person fears for their religion and they can't establish their religion. The second one is migration from the sins to obedience. And this is what the Prophet said here. What did he say? من هجر ما نهى الله عنه. The one who migrates from the sins. And there's another one called Hajar. Hajar, bi fat'il ha. And that means you boycott a person. And this is permissible bi'atibari al-masarih wal-mafasid. It is when you look at the benefits and the harms for religious reasons. If a person is a criminal, they commit sins, and you fear, and you know if you sit with them, they're going to cause you harm, you leave them. And you boycott them. Are you with me? And you stay away from them. But you can't boycott a Muslim for worldly reasons. You can't boycott a Muslim for worldly reasons. The Prophet said to us, alayhi salatu wasalam, that a believer should not boycott his believer brother for more than 3 days. So you have 3 days chance. Boycott him for 3 days. But after 3 days, you have to come back and give him salams. But who's the best from amongst you? وَخَيْرُهُمُ الَّذِي بَدَأ بِالسَّلَامِ. After 3 days is over, the one who gets the most reward is the one who starts the greetings. So you need to, after 3 days, start looking for him and see how he's doing. But you've been given 3 days. 3 days. The believer, that's worldly. But if it's for religious reasons, then it is, of course it has conditions stipulated to it. Na'am.
Chapter, whose Islam is the best? Or who is the best Muslim? Narrated by Abi Musa radiallahu anhu. Some people asked Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whose Islam is the best? i.e. who is a very good Muslim? He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, one who avoids harming the Muslims with his tongue and his hands.
Before that, like Imam al-Bukhari said, قال أبو عبد الله وقال أبو معاوية حدثنا داود عن عامر قال سمعت عبد الله عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وقال عبد الأعلى عن داود عن عامر عن عبد الله عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Does it have it in your copy? نعم. And Imam Bukhari mentions that. There's another narration Bukhari brings for it. Na'am, fadal.
Babu, ayyul islami afdal.
Here Bukhari rahimahullah, he says, Babu, chapter, ayyul islami afdal. What is the best Islam? Which Islam is the best? Na'am.
حدثنا سعيد بن يحيى بن سعيد القرشي. قال حدثنا أبي قال
who's his Abi, his father, he's referring to his father is يحيى بن سعيد القرشي الأموي. And his father is of the level of يحيى بن سعيد القطان and of that caliber. نعم.
قال حدثنا أبو بردة بن عبد الله بن أبي بردة عن أبي بردة عن أبي موسى رضي الله عنه.
أبو موسى is أبو موسى الأشعري. His name is عبد الله بن قيس. His name is what? عبد الله بن قيس. But he became very famous for his actual name, his kunya, Abu Musa al-Ash'ari. Naam. And he used to be a governor of Kufa for Uthman radiallahu anhu. He used to be. Uthman's time, Uthman elected him as a governor for Kufa, and he is min afadil al-sahaba, from the virtuous and noble companions, rahimahu radiyallahu ta'ala. And as you know, the Prophet ﷺ told us what? He told him, utita mizmaran min mazamiri Ali Dawood, right? He had a beautiful voice when it came to recitation of the Quran. Naam.
قالوا يا رسول الله أي الإسلام أفضل.
So here it says قالوا يا رسول الله. Some of the riwayat it says قلنا يا رسول الله. So قالوا is plural. It means they said to the messenger. They said to the prophet. And قلنا means we said to the prophet. And what it is قلنا, Abu Musa al-Ash'ari is referring to himself. Me and a group of the companions asked the prophet. And because there's another riwayat that says قلتو, I said. Talking about himself. نعم.
أي الإسلام أفضل.
What's the best Islam? Now pay attention. The best Islam. Hey, pay attention. You have to not just hear the hadith, but understand what's the best Islam. What's the best Islam?
قال من سلم المسلمون من لسانه ويده.
The best Islam is the person who the Muslims find safety from his tongue and his actions. That's the best Islam. Rasulullah was asked, أي الإسلام أفضل. What's the best Islam? You want to know what best Islam is? It is من سلم المسلمون من لسانه ويده. That the Muslims find safety from your tongue and they find safety from your hands. You don't cause harm. كَفُّ الْأَذَى عَنِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. You don't do takfir of the Muslims. You don't say the Muslims are kuffar. You don't shed their blood. You don't permit for yourself their honor and eat their flesh and backbite the Muslims.